when I was in like high school, college age, and people would ask me who my favorite superhero is, I would always say Batman. And I was always lying because my favorite superhero is Daredevil. And when I was in high school, college, that was kind of like a no-go because The Dark Knight had just come out and that was like the best movie ever. And Daredevil had the Ben Affleck movie. So it was not cool to say Daredevil. It was cool to say Batman. And they are very, very similar characters, minus the wealth. But a few, two, 3 years ago, they announced Netflix was going to do the Daredevil series. And last year, the first season dropped. And when that happened, I did something I'd never done before. And that was pace myself. And I sat down, I would watch an episode with Cody, and we would eat dinner and watch an episode, and that was it. And I'd wait a couple days, maybe a week, and we'd watch the next episode. And it let me just stretch the experience over the course of a few months and just savor every morsel of it as I watched it. And it was one of the best superhero adaptations I had seen. It was just absolutely solid from end to end. And then, you know, season 2 is coming out. And season 2 just came out, as I'm taping this, yesterday. And I just finished episode 1. As you can see on the TV behind me, as soon as I'm done taping, I'm going to watch episode 2. Because forget pacing myself this time around. I want all of this in my body as fast as possible. I'm going to avoid spoilers as much as I can. I may spoil the end of season 1, but you had all year to watch it. I'm not going to mess with even the first episode, cause it, like I said, it just came out yesterday. As of the time of this video coming out, it's only been out 2 days. That is not enough time to watch the whole series unless you're crazy like I am. And so I'm not going to really mess with it. And I've only seen the first episode, so I can't exactly spoil past that anyway. But just great, great TV. They pick up right where they left off. There's already, like, swerves going on. Fisk is out of power, so other organizations are trying to rise into his position in the city and take over the industries that he was running. And now that he's gone, someone else has to pick up the slack. But as it introduces a group that you think is going to take over, you shortly find out that there is no way this group is taking over, for reasons that if I say more will ruin it. But like, other than that, Daredevil Murdoch is finally in the costume. They teased us with that because it was in promotional materials. If you see the poster, like he's wearing the costume in the poster, and he was for season 1. But they gave us nothing until the last episode. You didn't even get a glimpse of it until, I think, the last 10 minutes. So it was really cool seeing him in costume, and it's not that biker slash fetish garb that Affleck was wearing. It looks purposeful. Everything about it looks like it has a purpose, a real-world purpose, and not just the purpose of looking cool. Except the horns, but even that's, like, I gotta scare people. That's the whole thing. So it's great seeing him in the suit. It's great seeing the dynamic with Foggy, Karen, and Murdoch, the kind of sexual tension, the triangle going on there. It's great to see. The humor's there. One of my favorite scenes from the comics is a bit where Murdoch hustles some people in a pool hall while telling Helen Keller jokes. And they don't go that far in this episode, but they hint to that. He's hustling at the pool table at the bar, and I lit up a bit inside. I did this about 6 times throughout the episode when different things were revealed or happening. It was just total nerdgasm. It was just a fantastic run. I am biased because he is my favorite and he's being done super well. But that being said, like, we're at a point right now with superhero movies where we are oversaturated. Others won't agree with me. Others will agree saying that we're close to being oversaturated. But I think we're there now. This month alone, this just came out. like Supergirl's happening on TV, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.'s happening, Civil War is coming out in a minute, Batman vs. Superman's coming out like next week. Like all of this is happening right now, and Deadpool just came out, and I feel like there's one more that I'm missing, which is just, it's like not even important enough that I can remember all of them at this point. And we've been hitting this like every year since like 2008 when the MCU started. And yes, the Marvel movies are good and I like to see them, but I still haven't seen like the second Thor movie. I haven't actually seen the 2008 Hulk movie yet. Like, I haven't seen Ant-Man yet, and it's not that I don't want to, it's that it's too much. It's too much. Like, Ant-Man came out 3 months after Age of Ultron, and I saw Age of Ultron and was a little bit disappointed. Like, it wasn't as good as the first one. And I was like, I don't feel like spending another $20 to go see Ant-Man in theaters. And I'll see it. I'll probably see it before I see Civil War. But, like, I just saw Deadpool, and that, like, hit all my expectations. But, like, it's... like, alright, I got my superhero fill, and now I've got Daredevil just came out, so it's like, I'm getting my superhero fill at home in hour-long chunks that I can watch at my leisure without paying more money than I'm already paying for Netflix. Like, I don't need to go spend $20, $40 if Cody goes with me to go see another superhero movie that I care about less than the one I'm getting at home. And we're, like, so at this point of oversaturation that it's nice to see stuff like Deadpool and Daredevil come out that do it different. Because try as they might to do the opposite, all the Marvel movies feel kind of the same. You can tell it's a Marvel movie you're watching. Different directors have their different flares, but they all have that same like producer influence coming in on the movie. So they all kind of feel the same. And the DC movies that are coming out, they all feel the same. It's a different feel, definitely. But oh, Suicide Squad's the other one. They all feel the same. Like, they kind of look the same, and they have the same, like, gritty darkness to them. And the ones that Fox are doing all have, the exception of Deadpool, all have that same, like, stink about them, because you know they're not going to be good, Fantastic Four. And it's so nice to have something come out, Daredevil, that's doing it different. It's, like, Deadpool's getting a lot of credit for being the first to go the R-rated route. Deadpool Season 1, like... there's that scene where he just... to avoid spoilers, if you've seen it, you know what this means. That is brutal. And I just finished Jessica Jones yesterday. I hadn't watched it because I'm a bad fanboy. But I binged it over the past 2 days so that I could be caught up for Daredevil. And there's the scene with the... you know what I'm talking about. Like, they went R-rated before Deadpool went R-rated. And it's just... there's innovation on the TV shows that Netflix is doing that you don't see in the movies, and it makes it more fresh. And I would rather see more of this than more of Age of Ultron. And as soon as I stop recording and start editing, I'm going to press play on that Apple remote and start episode 2, because I guess I don't feel like sleeping for the next couple of days. And I just want to get more of this in because it's that good. And the first episode at least ends on such a great cliffhanger that I just want to go in and find out what happens next. And they've got me. Like, Netflix and ABC Studios. And I didn't see Drew Goddard's name on this one, but I might be wrong. Like, the crew, they've got me hooked. They've got me hooked, and they hit it with this one. And I'm thankful for it because, like I said, it's either something different and fresh or more of the same. In a few years when they're on Deadpool Season 5, or not Deadpool, Daredevil Season 5, and it's all the same again, I may be singing a different tune, but right now, at the end of March in 2016, this is what I want to see more of and less of the same on a big screen. I think I've said enough. I really want to find out what happens next, so I'm going to get to that. Tomorrow, I'm looking at the movie that might be the reason why I started this whole thing. I mentioned it on my January 1st video. Tomorrow, I'm watching The Godfather. The classic, the movie to end all movies, The Godfather. The one that even my dad... called me out on. Texted me, just like, you haven't seen The Godfather? Tomorrow, that changes. And I think I've talked about hype before, but we may end up talking about hype again tomorrow, depending on how I feel. Hopefully not. But until then, like, share, subscribe, comment below. Tell me your favorite superhero that you tell the public, and your actual favorite superhero. But until tomorrow, bye.